important than you guys. Oh,
wow. Yay.
Don't cry, don't cry. Don't happy, cry. Happy, 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 happy.
Oh,
my oh,
gosh.
God.
In the name of God.
In the name of God.
Caitlin taking Matt to be my husband.
I, Caitlin, taking Matt to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
Matt and Caitlin, you've declared your consent and vows before God and before all the people here in this room. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with grace. Now that Matt and Caitlin have given themselves to each other by solemn vows and by the giving and receiving of these rings, on behalf of Christ and His church, I announce to you that they are husband and wife. Matt, you may now kiss the bride.
For you are mine at
school, I said to myself, thank God I still have Caitlin, who still liked me to come and got excited about it. When Wendy went off to college, I said, thank God I had Caitlin at home. When Wendy got married, I said, thank God I still have Caitlin's marriage. So I don't know what I'm going to do now. What has made it so much easier for me, though, is knowing what a good man she's married. Matt is such a good and kind and decent young man, and I know that he loves Caitlin very much, and as a father, there's really nothing else you can hope for. He is the way he is because he's a product of his family, Danny and Rhea, and of course Leslie, the little sister that Caitlin never had. So I do want to make a quick toast, and I read something really pretty recently that's very simple, but it really resonated with me. And it said, particularly in terms of couples, that when you're interacting with each other, if something would happen to go wrong, it said that the first one to apologize is the bravest. The first one to forgive is the strongest. And the first one to forget is the happiest. So if you'll join me in a toast for these folks, to Mr. and Mrs. Helveston, may you individually and collectively always be the bravest, the strongest, and the happiest. Cheers.
Cheers. Some say this world of trouble is the only what's your name?